What's your confidence level with Nash?
My confidence that
confidence level that Steve Nash could be an elite point guard this year?
Well, no, my confidence level is 100% that he's going to be an elite point guard now, whether that's for 20 minutes a game, 30 minutes a game, I don't know. We'll figure out that out. He's always going to be an elite point guard. His knowledge of the game and the way he, as well as he shoots, he's always going to put up good numbers. I mean, even last year, I don't even know what his numbers are, but was it 13 points, probably shot over 50%. So there's not many point guards that can do that. I just hope he can do it all year and be here and be ready for the playoffs. So that's the main thing, and I don't know that. Nobody knows that.
How do you see the backup spot behind him shaping up with Steve?
Almost all our positions will be determined during the preseason and training camp. And the good thing about what we have is that Steve Blake can play the two. He can play the one. So can Farmar. So we have a lot of guys we can move around different positions. And the players will determine that as they go forward. Not us always the best player. It's always the combination of players, what's function, what doesn't.
But at least once training camp is over, is it the plan to have someone definitively behind Steve, or would it just kind of depend on the matchup?
No. There'll always somebody will be somebody out, because I'm a big believer in players have to know their role and their positions and feel comfortable. This league's hard enough to compete anyway, and if you're looking over your shoulder or you don't feel comfortable with what you're doing, it's hard to compete in it.
Last year you said a lot of guys say they
last year I said a lot of things.
they do know their roles, they just don't want to do them.
Well, guys, come on. When you hear some players saying, well, I'll do anything it takes to win, if it means they've never finished their statement, you know, if everything goes my way and I'm a focal point and I get the ball when I want it, then I won't do anything it takes to win. So it's just the way life is, and players know. Players know. There's no way, I'm just going to disguise it so you won't know what your role is, you know, just.
Is it just coming in, you have training camp, maybe a less fractured situation? You
know, yeah. Well, the biggest thing is that the expectations are out of the roof last year. We don't have that this year. And for me personally, coming in, I had to go through a litany of people. Should I play that guy, this guy? Set this guy down for a couple games, check the other guy out without any practices really to look at it. And you had to go through it. And we were losing in the meantime. And I thought toward the end of the year, by the time we figured out who can play and who can't, not that they can't play, but not with this group, and play the team at the level or the rhythm that they need to play to win, just took a while. And you know, I understand where I am, but I don't know of any other way to do it.
What are the doctors telling you as to when Kobe is going?
They're not telling me. They're just.
What's your gut feel?
I have no idea. My gut feel is that I'm about ready for lunch. That's about it. I have no idea. No idea. Nobody knows until I'm sorry.
Do you feel like you're in any kind of hot seat?
I'm going to try to get to practice this afternoon. If I can make it this afternoon. Yeah, everybody's on a hot seat. I mean, obviously, this is L.A. It's normal. But I don't sit around and fret about it. But I think if you ask 29 other coaches, yeah, they all say, yeah.
That's how many coaches lost their jobs.
That's what I'm saying. So, you know, there's only 13 got fired last year. So, yeah, obviously, I think every coach feels the exact same way. But we're excited and know that we're lucky to have one of the 30 jobs, and we're going to do the best we can to make it successful.
Did you have, detox after last summer?
Detox? Yeah. No, it was like, detox. Just living in L.A. is a detox. That's no place better.
But, how did last year rank in terms of tough years you've been through? I know that there were some bad ones in New York, too.
Well, same. I mean, you know, just the interesting things are interesting sometimes, just a little bit different. But nothing, you know. I wouldn't trade it for the world.